Welcome back to my channel, Statistics for Applied Linguistics. I'm Dr. Marnie Menegra, and in this video, we are going to look at how to do the repeated measures ANOVA. So the repeated measures ANOVA, we will be doing this in JASP, so we will go live at the end of this video. But first, let's look at when we would use the repeated measures ANOVA. So a repeated measures means that all of the participants are exposed to the different measures of the study. So this is the test we would use when there are two or more groups for a pre-test post-test design or pre-test mid-test post-test delayed post-test design. So if you have multiple different types of tests or measures and you have different groups going through all of the same measures, then this is when we would use this test. So the testing is the repeated measure. So what are the steps in JASP? The first thing we would do is code the data in Excel and make sure to have one column per test per group. Then you save this as a CSV file, open the file in JASP, make sure all the labels show scale data because these are test scores. Then you would go to ANOVA and select repeated measures ANOVA, and under the repeated measures factors, enter the group names and the testing names. Drag the data to the proper field in the repeated measures cells. Click on descriptives and estimated effect size, go to post hoc test, add the variables, click the confidence intervals, go to display and click on the descriptive plots and then analyze the output. So let's see what that will look like with some screenshots here. So here I've got experimental pretest, experimental group with the post test, control group with the pretest and control group with the post test. Remember for the labels, in the top line in Excel, you cannot have any spaces. Okay, so now I'm going into JASP. I'm going to find the file and open the CSV file. I've got all of the data set to scale data. And then I'm going to go up to ANOVA, click on repeated measures. Now under repeated measures factors, this is where I'm going to put the labels. So I can type in group, experimental, and control. If there was a third group, we could put that here. Testing, pre-test, post-testing. If there's multiple tests, you can put those here as well. So you can have many groups with many different types of tests. So then once we have that entered, we're going to drag the experimental pre-test data over into this file, post-test, and the controls as well. And that's going to automatically give us this contingency table on the right-hand side. Now, of course, just looking at the contingency table, we can see that the p-value for the group is significant and for the testing, it is significant, but the group times the testing, it does not show that it's significant. So we're going to go get some more information from JASP. What we can do is we can click on display and click on the descriptives. So we will get that in a contingency table here. And the estimates of the effect size, we're going to get eta squared, which we're going to see in the final column in the first contingency table here. So we can see that there is a strong effect size for the group, not quite as strong of an effect size for the testing. So now when we go into post hoc tests, we can click on confidence intervals at 95%, grab our variables over here, and then click on the 2 key. Now we can look at the lower and upper for the confidence intervals at 95% and where it does not cross zero. So here we have experimental pretest to experimental post-test. This is significant. Experimental pretest to control post-test. This is also significant. And control pretest to the control post-test is significant. And experimental post-test to the control post-test is not significant. So we can see where exactly there is an interaction effect or where one variable is affecting another. Okay, so now we can also then go to display and go to descriptive plots. In factors, you can put testing in the horizontal axis, group in the in separate lines, and you can see a difference of how these two groups were performing here. Okay. So Then we need to analyze the results. The ANOVA showed a significant difference between the groups and also between the testing, and the effect sizes are high. The Tukey post hoc test shows the differences between the experimental pretest and experimental post test, control pretest and control post test, and the experimental pretest with the control post test. These are all significant. So we can see that the pretest to post test is where we're finding the majority of the significance. Okay, and effect size, remember with eta squared, 0.14 is large, 0.06 is medium. If we go back, we can see the effect size for the testing is 0.09, so that is a medium to large effect size. It would fall right in the middle between the two. Okay, so now we're going to go live into JASP. I'm going to stop sharing my screen and I'm going to open JASP. And now that I have JASP open, I'm going to go to the file. In this case here, I have the file on my desktop. I modified the data because here I wanted to show a second experimental group. So what happens when we have two experimental groups and one control group? The data is fine, everything is in scale, so we can go right to the repeated measures ANOVA. First thing I need to do is put in the groups. So let's put in experimental one, or sorry, I'm going to put group here. And under level, this is where I'm going to label them. Experimental one. We'll put the control here because I had that in the middle on the data sheet. And then next level, experimental two. Now, here we're going to put in the testing. And for level one, I'm going to put the pretest. And level two, I could put the post test. Now, again, if I had a mid test or a delayed post test, I could just put that in here. Now, if there are also new factors, you can enter new factors, but we've just got the pretest, post test design with three groups. Now, because I put these in order, I can just click on the arrow or I can drag them over. So we've got the experimental one here for pre and post, control, pre and post, and experimental two, pre and post. So now I have my contingency table building. I'm going to make this a little larger and we can see the group and the testing. These are both significant. Group times testing is not significant. Let's get the descriptive plots. Or the descriptive contingency table, which will give us the means and standard deviation. But let's get the effect size here. So now we've got the eta squared, and we've got two of these have a mid to high level effect size. Now we're going to go to the post hoc test. We're going to take our variables over, and we've got the confidence intervals at 95%. We're going to switch this over to Tukey, because we've been using the Tukey test in this class. And so now with the post hoc test here, I can go through and see for the, I'm just going to make this a little bit larger, experimental one group for the pretest is going to be significant with their the post test for experimental group one, and also the control group one, and also the experimental two post tests. So the difference is significant for all three of these post tests. The control group pretest is significant with the control post test and just the control post test only. The experimental group two pretest is significant with the control post test and the experimental two post test. And then the experimental one post test is significant with the, well, it's not significant here at all. And then the control post test with the experimental two post test is not significant. So I can see all of those there. Now, finally, let's go to descriptive plots. We're going to put the group in the horizontal axis and the testing in separate lines. Now, when you get what looks squished here, we can drag this out. Test post test. Okay, so we can see the difference between the experimental one group, pretest, post test, control group, and experimental two. I'm actually going to move these back. Okay, so I've just switched these. So we've got separate lines for each of the groups now. And you can see that experimental one group is the circles. Experimental two are the squares, and the control group are the dark circles there. So you can see the difference of pretest to post test of each of these groups. Okay, so this gives us all the data that we need to write up our results section for the repeated measures ANOVA. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.